All right, guys, how's it going? It's These Banglers. We're out here today talking all about fishing like always. We're talking all about flies today. We're talking flies specifically, how to five different ways you guys can fish a fly. I want to talk to you guys about, you know, how effective they are, how you can fish small flies. Some of these size are going to be, you know, 18, 20, 22. They're going to be very small. And that's for particular applications, whereas you've got larger flies, which are, you know, 14, 12, 10, 8, you know, that mid-range section. Then you've got these really large flies, and those large flies, you know, being 2, 4, 6, 8, well, mainly 2, 4, 6, but 8's kind of considered slightly larger. These flies are generally, like the smaller ones, they're going to be like literally the size of a micro insect, and, you know, as you get to those larger sizes, you know, they go all the way up to 4 inches in length. So let's talk about some of the different ways we're going to fish these flies, some of the different applications. So first of all, let's start with the small flies first, you know, sizes 16, 18, 20, 22. Those flies are going to be used for, you know, really, really light line, you know, a lot of 2 pound, max 3 pound test line, you know, ultra light setups, fly rods and such that are just really for, oh, I want to say a lot of creek fish and a lot of smaller fish in general. Not to say they don't catch big fish, but definitely targeting those smaller fish. And as you upsize with those flies, you know, in that mid-range section we talked about, 8, 10, 12, 14, you know, that's really when you start, you know, you start getting a bigger profile. It's a profile, in my opinion, that starts to attract more fish. So you know, you have the ability to catch more fish. You have the ability to hook into a variety of different species. Whereas, you know, I mean, they all have that, you know, that wonderful aspect where you can catch anything at any given moment, any given day on a fly. But I'm usually putting a fly in the face of these fish because there's something natural in that particular body of water I'm trying to imitate. And I know they're keying in on it. So with those mid-range size flies, I like to do, you know, a lot of nymphing, a lot of stripping, a lot of dry flies, you know, dry fly fishing with those mid-range flies. It's very effective. And you can get away with line all the way up to that 6 pound range. It's a bit high. A lot of people would prefer to go somewhere between that 3 and 6. So that's really good for those mid-range flies. And, you know, the larger flies, I generally tend to throw on 8 pound line, fluorocarbon all the way with all these. And one of the reasons I upsize is because we're talking a 4 inch fly. And sometimes it might be a streamer fly, and you're targeting bigger fish. You gotta have that stronger line. So a lot of times, you know, let me tell you how I'm gonna rig, say, some of these flies. You know, I'm gonna put them under an indicator, some kind of a float device, an indicator, bobber, whatever you got at your disposal. The second way you're gonna fish them is you're gonna Carolina rig them. You know, Carolina rig them has, you know, the barrel sinker, you know, comes to the snap, and, you know, you've got your leader to your bait, and you've got your split shot rig, which is essentially being able to take a few, to anywhere from one to a few split shot and slide them up and down, really vary the length, really have a lot of control with the length of those. They're also removable, so you can kind of adjust as you go if you're trying to get in the perfect water column or whatnot. So there's that whole way to go. And another way that I really like to fish them, you know, we talked about fishing them on top. I think, yeah, we did that. And I like to strip them. I think we talked about that. Stripping them is where you're going to strip different amounts of line out of your fly reel. So might be 1, might be 2, might be 4 inches, might be different, you know, cadence, slower, faster. A lot of this is going to have to do with the time of the year in particular. Guys, just remember, there's other ways to fish your flies. I like to drop shot my fly. It's very effective, very, very effective. You know, catch a lot of fish, catch big fish, drop shot streamers. You know, I'm also big on drifting a fly, okay? And I've also trolled a fly and been, you know, quite effective. So let's say you want to get the mid-water column, you can troll a fly. Let's say you want to go deep, you want to fish really deep, troll a fly, you can get away with it. You can catch all kinds of different species of fish. It's very effective. You know, just remember, the fly is very versatile. So another way I fish the fly is on a, it's like a small little clear bubble. You can fill it with different amounts of water, you know, allows it to either be, you know, on the bottom or mid-range or all the way at the top of the water column. So there's just a variety of ways to fish the fly. And in general, you know, there's also making the fly dance. There's also working the fly in its natural like motion. So that's all stuff you got to read up. You got to spend the time. And I hope this video helps you guys. Fishing fly is really effective, not just for trout, not just for panfish. So keep that in mind when you guys go out next time. Stay tuned.